What is going on, guys? My name is MKC Technology, and welcome to another tech video. In today's video, I'm going to be talking about the new platform of NiceHash and giving some information on it. If you haven't subscribed to my channel, please subscribe to my channel now. Like for more videos, comment down below, and all the links to my social media is in the description box down below, so please be sure to check that out. With that being said, let's get started. Come on, let it go. Right here is the new website and also like the new platform of NiceHash. Obviously, it's not like really the new platform of NiceHash, just the website right here. But this is like I said, this is the new platform of NiceHash. Now, this is the dashboard for the website, and it shows you a lot of statistics. It shows you your current balance. It shows how much you got paid or your recent activity of how much you got paid. It shows your active and inactive rigs. It shows that you can start and stop your rigs from Bitcoin mining. Now, in order to stop and start your rigs from Bitcoin mining, the operating system has to be open at all times. So, like if I were to hit start all rigs, it would give me an error code right here due to the fact that NiceHash EXE is not even opened right now. So if I were to go to mining right here, it will show a lot more statistics. It shows my current profitability if I were to be mining for a 24-hour basis. It shows my unpaid balance and my next payout. Now, the next payout will only work if you are currently mining. Since I am not currently mining right now, then this countdown doesn't even matter. The mining tab right here, it shows my current balance, it shows my rigs, and it shows that I also have an RX 590 because that's what I named the rig. It shows my current history and my stats right here, and my mining history of how much I got paid. Now, also in the mining tab, or this tab right here, it gives you an option to download the miner or add an ASIC. So basically, you have three options right here. Your NiceHash miner for Windows 10. And correct me if I'm wrong, I believe you could do this on Mac OS. Correct me in the comment section down below. You also have the option for NiceHash OS, which is an advanced Linux-based operating system for mining farms. And you can also connect your ASIC device by creating a worker name, selecting your algorithm, whether it's SHA-256, which is the algorithm for Bitcoin. And you can do Equihash, Skunk, Beam, Grin, CryptoNiteR, Cuckoo, Cycle, and stuff like that. And you also have to select your location of where the server you want to mine from. Or I guess that's what it is. I'm not really sure. You can also find your mining address right here. You can copy and paste it in the application or in the operating system. Or if you're doing ASIC mining, you can copy and paste your mining address there as well. So you also have the exchange section. So, which if I go into simple view, obviously my country, which is the United States, is not currently supported. So this tab will not really show up, but you can go into trade view, and it also says that my country is not supported either, but you can trade Litecoin, XRP, Zcash, Bitcoin Cash, and Ethereum. I'm not sure if it's Ethereum Classic or the new version of Ethereum. Correct me if ETC is Ethereum Classic or ETH is Ethereum Classic. Correct me in the comment section down below. You can trade all these other cryptocurrencies into Bitcoin. So let's actually go back to the page right here. Now, you have your hashing power marketplace. Now, you have the European side right here, and then you have the USA side right here. So basically, what this tab is for is you can buy hashing power from other people who have a spear Sphere mining rig lying around who is lending out their hashing power from their mining rig. And what this basically does is once you rent out some of their hashing power, you're able to do cloud mining through NiceHash. Now, you can create a pool for your mining rig where you're renting out your hashing power. Now, if you go to this tab right here, it shows that you can create a pool or add a pool right here. And you can choose whatever algorithm you want to do it for. And you can create a name for the pool. You add your stratum, host name, and IP right here. And also the port number, and your username, and your password. And you can also test the pool by clicking here. Now, my orders is where you go to show what kind of orders you have open for, like, if you have rented out any hashing power from somebody. Now, it also shows your wallets right here. You can access your wallet in three or four different places. So here's one, here's two, here's three, and here's four. So if I were to click on this, it goes to the same area. If I were to go back and I were to click on this, it goes to the same place. So now, here's one thing I need to get into or talk about real quick. Where are your old funds? And it's basically the question that's right here. So you can go ahead and read ahead, and I'm just going to go ahead and read this out loud. This is the new NiceHash wallet page. You have a new Bitcoin wallet address as well as new wallets for multiple other current cryptocurrencies. Your old balance is still available here, and you can transfer your Bitcoin funds from the old platform by making a withdrawal on the old platform to your new wallet address. If you have used the same email address on the old platform and new platform, your funds will automatically be transferred at the end of the transition period. For those who want more information on what they're saying here, let me go to this support page that I did. So basically, I asked them a question because I have some money, which is $9.02, which is not much, on the old platform that has not been put into my actual wallet yet. This is actually pending funds. So let me go ahead and read what they said. They said, "Hello, once we have closed down the old platform in the future, the date is not yet to be announced, but probably the old platform will be fully functional until September of 2019. We will transfer all funds to your new account, even the unpaid mining balance. Please note that this will only be possible if you have used the same email address for the registration on the old and new platform. You can also make a regular blockchain withdrawal from the old BTC address to your new BTC address. For any other external BTC wallet address, or any other external BTC wallet address, but please note that that the mining balance for withdrawal is 0.0011 BTC. And you can go ahead and find out any more information that you need to know at this link right here, which I'll link in the description box, in the description box down below if you guys need to go ahead and look up or look for any more information. Now, in the link, it does says live updates, which means they will probably talk about any thing that's going to be happening with the old platform of NiceHash and also any other stuff that's happening with the new platform of NiceHash. But yeah, that'll be it for today, guys. I really hope you guys enjoyed this video. Please be sure to leave a like, comment down below, and subscribe to my channel. All the links to my social media is in the description box down below, so please be sure to check that out. With that being said, I'm MKC Technology. I'm out. Peace. Brother, it's caught in the crossfire. It's caught in the crossfire.